Welcome to Digital Electronics Lab. So today we're going to discuss about one of the experiment, that is MUX implementation. So here it is the title, the topic what we are going to take in here it is. You can see that MVV MUX implementation. Let's move on to that. So here it is, what is the aim of our experiment? Here aim of our experiment here it is, the given a four variable logic expression, simplify it using entered variable map method and implement using MUX. Means they will give a four variable logical expression. You need to simplify with the help of map enter variable technique, and you need to implement this one using MUX. Okay, that is our aim of our experiments. And how to get the four variable expression? So let's see that. So I'm going to take on a four variable expressions here. So four variables I'm going to take on here, it is A, B, C, D, and summation of m, mean term equation, they are given as a 2, 3, 4, 5, 13, comma 14, and don't care conditions, they are given as 8, 9, 10, 11. Now, first thing it is, you need to identify which one we are going to consider as my MVV. So if they're not going to mention anything, so default in come to lab, we are going to take as a last variable. Here you can see D as my MVV. Suppose if you taken a variable has a K, L, M, N, N it is, we are going to take it as a map entered variable. Okay. So first you need to identify the map entered variable, and this is a four variable logical expression what they are given. Once you got the expression, next thing it is how to write the truth table. That's very important thing. It is how to simplify. You see that you have a four variables A, B, C, D. If you have a four variables means how many combinations you'll get? Just see that 2 to the power of 4. 2 to the power of 4 is nothing but a 16. 16 is nothing but it is ranges from 0 to 15. Right. So first you write the 0 to 15. This is an optional. If you want, you can write. Otherwise, directly you can represent the binary values. Okay. So I need to represent the 0 to 15. Okay. Once you got the decimal number, you write the respective binary numbers. You just see that. 0 means 40, 00000, 0001, next it is 0010, next it is 001. Similarly, the 15 is nothing but I'm going to return as 111. So respective binary numbers, you just write here. Once you write, the next topic it is, so already taken D as my map entered variable. You can see here it is, my D value it is continuously changes to 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 0 to 1. Yes, yeah, I'm going to taken here it is. So D as my map entered variable here, it is continuously changes 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 0 to 1. Okay, once you got this, next I need to write the Y equation. So how to write Y? By seeing the mean term and the, here it is don't care condition, easily I can write this. Just see here it is. So in this case, you just see 2, 3, 4, 5, 13, 14. Where is my 2? Here. 2, you need to make it as a 1. Next 3, you need to make it as a 1. Next it is a 4, 5, yes, 4 and 5, 13 and 14, yes, I'll go for 13 and 14, make it as a 1s. Next, you see the don't care conditions. Here it is don't care conditions are 8, 9, 10, 11. You just see that 8, 9, 10, 11 you have, just you need to consider as an x. In this x, in future, become here it is 1. Okay, just see, first you need to fill the values, here it is 1, 1, 1. Next, 8, 9, 10, 11 is there. This 8, 9, 10, 11, we are going to fill the values by x. But it is an SOP expression, and then we can replace my x value. X is nothing but don't care conditions. These x values, we can replace it by 1s. So next, what is my task? I'm going to replace these x terms by 1. Just see, I'm going to replace this all the 4 values by 1. Once you replace, then you already know the MVV rule. Then you easily will get the map entered variables. So with the help of MVV rules, so what are the MVV rules? You know that. So these are all the things. See, I'm going to take on one of the variable as my MVV. First rule say that if both the outputs are 0, 0, you're going to write the 0. If both the outputs are 1, 1, you need to write it as a 1. And if it is 0, 1 is there, then it is matching with your MVV because this is MVV 0, 0 and MVV also it is here it is 1, 1. Then that MVV variable we are going to write here it is, write MVV. And its complemented form is there, means MVV value it is 0, 1 And if you have a 1, 0, then it's a complemented value. Then you need to write the complement of MVV. So leave this one. At least you remember these 4 rules we are going to apply here. Now, so when come to here, you can see that both the values are 0, 0. Because of both the values are 0, 0, I'm going to write it as 0. Next condition, I'll take it as an 1, 1. So just see that both the values are 1, 1. I'm going to write it here. It is 1. Next, you see the outputs. Both U22 you need to consider and just check it out. Next, it is 1, 1. So if both the values are 1, 1, I'm going to write it as 1. Next, 0, 0 is there, just 0. Next, it is both the values are 1, 1. I'm going to write it 1. But this case, it is not the previous cases. It is a totally different. You just see that. So just here, I'm going to take D as my map entered variable. My D value it is 0 and Y value also it is 0. Then D value it is 1 and my Y value also it is 1. Then directly I can take as my map entered variable entry. We are going to take as this variable, that is D. This D I'm going to consider here it is. You can see that. So with the help of this is only we are telling if it is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. If it is same thing, then you need to write D. And second case, you just see the complement to each other. If it is 0 is there, you have a 1. You have a 1, next you need to take it as a 0. Complement to each other, then I'm going to take it as a D bar. So I'm going to take it as in a D bar. Means here it is D variable is there, that's why D bar. Otherwise, if you are given any other variable, for example, KLMN, N they're given means N bar you need to consider. And I'm going to take it here, it is D dash. I'm going to take it here. Okay. This is about map entered entries once we got. But we are not going to simplify this with respect to KMap. But what they are telling, you need to implement using MUX. So if you take a MUX, next question it is arises, how many input MUX I need to choose? Just see that here it is 4 variable. Out of 4 variable, and first 3 variable act as a select line for the MUX. And here we are going to reduce my 4 variable to 3 variables. 2 to the power of 3 variable is nothing but I'll get a 8 combination. These are the 8 combinations what I am getting. So here it is total 16 become now here it is 8. Now and second thing, ABC here act as a select lines, and in order to represent this one, 8 will get the 8 combinations. 2 to the power of 3 variables means I'll get 8 combinations. So 8 inputs I have, then it's required 8 is to 1 MUX. Okay. So you have taken a 1 MUX here it is. Just I'm going to take on it is 8 is to 1 MUX. So in the 8 is to 1 MUX, in this case, I am going to take on as an input. You can take it as a D also, your wish. So here I'm going to take on I as my input, Y as my output. And if you take a 8 inputs, then 3 select lines it will get. Because you already know that 2 to the power of 3 is nothing but 3 select lines you have. Nothing but 2 to the power of n number of inputs having n number of select lines. Okay, so here it is my ABC here act as a select lines, and here it is my inputs. I'm talking about the inputs here. You can see that. So these 8 and values what you are getting, these are act as the inputs. I taken as I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6 and I7. Then if my values it are 0, 0, 0, I naught value. What is I naught value? 0, it is a output. If similarly, if you go for 1, 0, 0, 1, it is a output. Similarly, if it is 1, 1, 1, it is a D complement, you need to get the output. So in this way, we can verify that. So before going to that verification and how to construct, so let's move on to how to write the block diagram of this based on these values. Okay, so here it is, I'm going to take and it is already told that 8 inputs and 3 select lines and 1 output. Yeah, first write the one block of 8 is to 1 MUX. 8 inputs you need to write. First, identify zeros. Where is my zeros? So here it is. I naught value it is 0 and I3 value also it is 0. First case, I naught value it is 0. I3 value here it is 0. So because of 0, 0, what I'm going to do here it is, in this block, I'm going to connect I0 and I3 inputs. You just see that I0 and I3 inputs are connected to the ground. Just I'm going to connect it to the ground. Okay. Once it is over, next it is, we need to search for ones. How many ones you have? You have a I1, 1, I2, 1, I4, 1, I5, 1. Just see that. So you need to give the ground and this potential is equal to 0. Next condition it is, you need to search for this. So this one we already connected to the ground. Next here it is, I1, I2, I4, I5. You can see that I4, I5, I1, I2. These four we need to connect it to where? 1. 1 is nothing but we need to connect it to VCC. So whose potential it is generally we are going to take as a plus 5 volts. Clear? So once you did, next you can see that I6 input you have. So we need to looking for map entered variable, that is D. So just connect I6 to D directly. You can see here it is. I'm going to connect my I6 to D. Next, I7, we are getting the D complement. How to get the D complement? We are going to use one NOT gate for that. So just I'm going to use I7. I7, it is connected to D with an NOT gate. So I'm going to use. So I'll get the value of D dash. Okay. Next, once it is clear, next I need to represent the select lines, right? Here it is my select lines. Okay, and one more output. Here it is output. I'm going to take as a Y. So I'll get the Y as my output for 8:1 max. And select lines, I'm going to take on here it is ABC. ABC it is my select lines. So how I'm going to take on here it is ABC are my select lines I'm going to take on. Okay. This is the implementation of my MVV into 8:1 max. But next task it is, we need to realize that one, whether it is working or not, right? So now to do this one, so we are going to use a high C's for this. We have a one high C for 8:1 max as well as NOT gate. Let's choose the high C's. So for in order to get the NOT gate, we already know that IC7404, it is one of the high C what we are going to use for the NOT gate. In this case, pin number 1, it is the input, and pin number 2, it is the output. You can see that it is a one NOT gate. Output one, input one, output one. Totally have a 6 gates, but out of that I'm going to use only one IC for this. Next you see that, so and 7404 as well as one more IC used for an 8:1 max, that is taken as a IC74151. And IC7404, it's a 14 pin IC, 7 it is connected to the ground and 14 it is connected to VCC. Next, so what is the pins? I'm going to use this gate only. So this you need to mention as a pin number 1, you can see here, and output we are going to represent it as 2. Okay, you can see that 1 and 2. Once you mention the NOT gate, next I'll go for 8:1 max. So IC diagram. So this is my 8:1 max IC diagram. You have a I3, I2, I1, I0 as well as Y. And if you want, you can get the complemented value. And enable bar also is there. In this case, I'm not going to use enable. But it is a 16 pin IC. You need to consider this. So here it is 16 pin we are connected to the VCC. And pin number 8, we are going to connect it to the ground. Okay. Now, so I need to number this one, right? So how we are going to numbering? Just see that. What is my I0? What is the pin number of I0? You just see that I0 pin number here it is 4 is there. Then you need to represent here it is 4. Just see, it's a 4. Similarly, I3 value, it is a 1. You just represent here it is 1. Similarly, I4, 15. I5, 14. You just see that. So I'm going to use. Similarly, I1 it is a 3. And next, I2 it is a 2. Similarly, I6, 13. I7 value, 12. So up to here it is not an issue. By seeing this one easily you can write. Next task it is, so I'm going to represent a select line. This carefully you need to observe that. Here it is, S0 is nothing but my LSP value and S2 it is nothing but my MSP. Here it is, A it is my MSP, C it is my LSP. That's why first S2 value, it will come to A, S1 nothing but B, S0 nothing but it is C. So here it is, the pins are 9, 10, 11. Just see that 9 is MSP value, that is S2 value, 10 and 11. Carefully you need to enter the values. Next, what is my output? I'm going to take under Y, that is pin number 5. Just represent. So this is just representation by seeing the IC74151. So you'll just implement and just represent the pin numbers. Once you represent, then easily we can realize using DeltSim simulator, and you just see that S2, S1 and S0 I'm going to connect it to here. So let's see how we are going to realize it using DeltSim simulator. Okay, once you open the DeltSim simulator, what is the first task? We need to choose the ICs. What are the ICs you have? IC74151, another IC is IC74044 for the NOT gate. These are two, you already know that. So first I'm going to choose IC7404 and IC74151. Just in order to get this one, what I'm going to do, just I'll go to add IC, select one of the base. I'm going to choose this base, and I'll choose IC74. Just I'll go select the base, IC74151. So somewhere it is there, just search that one. You can see that IC74151 is there. It's a multiplexer. Just select and add IC. Next, one more IC, IC7404, that is for NOT gate. You just see that, then you need to select that. So what I'm going to do, add IC, select the base, 7404. You can see that it's an inverting gate. Just select, add IC. Once you did this connection, next task it is, you need to connect to VCC and ground first. So when come to this IC, pin number 18, this is a pin number, it's a 16 pin IC. Just see that. So 1, 2, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. This is the 16th pin. 16th pin, I'm going to connect it to VCC. Just click on connect. And pin number 8, we are going to connect it to the ground. And so in this case, pin number 14, it is connected to VCC. And pin number 7, we are going to, because there is a difference. It is a 14 pin IC. 7404 is a 14 pin IC. 151 is a 16 pin IC. So that's why we are going to connect to the VCC and ground. Once you connect the VCC and ground, just see the circuit, how we are going to do the connections. Just see, it's a final circuit what I am getting. Pin number 1 and 4, you just see that, don't worry about I3, I0, just see, pin number 1 and 4, it is connected to the ground. So just do that connection, pin number 1, just click and connect it to the ground, and 1 and 4, unity connect to the ground. Okay, next 2, 3, 14, 15, just see that 2 you need to connect it to VCC, 3 you need to connect it to VCC, 14 this one you need to connect to VCC, and 15 this one also you need to connect it to VCC. So something, if it is missing, means you need to connect. So you just see that 14, 2, 3 and 14, 15, it is connected. Once it is over, then it will come to here. Pin number 13, you need to connect it as a D. Just see that. Pin number 13. So 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13, you are going to consider as a my D. Okay. Next. Next, so it's connected to D. Next, you just see the circuit 13 and you have a 12. 12, it is not connected directly. So now you see that pin number 1, it is connected to the NOT gate. D, it is connected to here, and 2, it is the output. So in order to do this one, so what I'm going to do, so this D, it is connected to pin number 1, just connect it here, and 2, it is the output. Where I need to connect, it is connected to pin number 12. Just see that 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So once this connection is over, next 9, 10, 11 are my select lines. You just select 9, 10, 11. Just see that 8, 9, it is taken as a somewhere you connect. And 10, it is a B. And next one, it is C. Now these are A, B, C, and this is a D. That's a ground. And pin number 5, you need to connect it to the output. Okay, so once you did this connection, so connection it's over, I think. So all everything it's be connected. Now we need to realize that how, just see that what it's telling, my select lines are 000. I need to get I not as my output. So how to get, just see that. So just switch on the trainer kit. So my select lines, here it is, this is A, this is B and C. 0, 0, 0 means, see, I'm getting it is a 0 only. Next, so select lines are 0, 0, 1, I need to get 1. See, select lines, I'll make 0, 0, 1, you need to get it is 1. Similarly, you just verify all the conditions. I'll go for this 101, 101 also you need to get as a 1. 1, this is make it, sorry. Here it is 101. If you make 101, I'm getting it is 1 only. So major thing it is how to verify for D values. See, my select lines are 110. It's totally depend upon my D. So how? Just see 110. Just see 110. The value, suppose this is my D, right? If 0 is there, 0 only it is coming. If I make 1, I'm getting 1 only. Okay. Same value it is coming, right? It following my D value. So this not happen in the previous case. For example, the values are 0, 0 means what is the value I'm getting? 0, 0. On that case, if 1 or 0, whatever the changes, it's not depend upon my D value. I'm getting same 0 only. For example, 0, 0, 1 make, it's a 1 only. If I change my D value also, it is not changing. Okay. But only if make it is 1, 1, 0, then you are getting the values. It is D value. See, if 0 is there, 0 it's coming. I'll make it as a 1. You're getting 1. Okay. So next it is I'll make 1, 1, 1. You just see here in the table. If the values are 1, 1, 1, I need to get the D complement. How to get the D complement? It is 1. You're getting 0. Next you make it is a 0. You're getting 1. So I'm getting the complemented value, right, for 1, 1, 1. So in this way, you can realize. So this is about MUX implementation using MVV method. Thank you.